Speech impediment. If people understand what I am saying, maybe then that's okay. But thanks for noticing. Anyway, he continues. There are few things in life less humorous than people who attempt to be funny. Comedy and tragedy are two sides of the coin. Funny is something that happens spontaneously, and it has sadness and confusion and pain. And the fact that you can distill comedy is a product, is a joke in and of itself. I have no idea what that meant. I don't even understand it, but I read it anyway. Anyway, he continues by saying, people who profess to be humorists usually received too little or too much attention as children and spend the rest of their lives compensating. Well, it's possible that I have a very troubled life, so I have to spend it compensating. I mean, I'm just probably a very compensating person to compensate what I have. And since I have nothing, I need to compensate. I mean, there's nothing wrong with compensating. I always like to get my money back when the cashier at the supermarket makes a mistake and doesn't double my coupon. So I go to the customer service and I get compensated. I get my double coupon. Glad you picked up on that. Anyway, I'm getting out of breath. As for your show, I admire your ambition. Thanks! But question the intelligence and originality that you insist is so prominent in your work. Thank you for questioning my intelligence. I guess you probably have realized that I don't have any intelligence. You see, not too long ago, I did an IQ test. You know, an IQ. Oh, is that my speech impediment problem again? I meant to say my intelligence test. And I was scored as a retard. But I accept the fact that I am not intelligent. I don't mind. It has its benefits, you know. But thank you for questioning my intelligence. Now you have an answer. I am not intelligent. Anyway, he continues to say, have you ever heard of Doodle Weevil? Not that Doodles was in any way intelligent, but the format seems a bit familiar. Doodle, yeah, I don't know who Doodle Weevil is, but I do know Yankee Doodle. Am I a Yankee? Yankee Doodle came to town riding on a pony, stuck a feather in his hat and called it macaroni. Am I a Yankee Doodle? I like being a Yankee Doodle. Thanks for noticing that I am a Yankee. Anyway, I'm getting tired. It's such a long letter and I feel so out of breath. Anyway, it's so easy to sling arrows at the mass media, but it's hardly a profound insight to suggest that their primary motivation is to make money. That's what they do. So you think it's okay that the mass media is trying to make money and that they're always selling a product to you? Well, I think that must be great. I love it. I love it when the mass media presents me with a bunch of top 40 music to listen to. I love it. I love it when they present me with a bunch of top 10 blockbusters. I love it. I Well, you see, that's what the problem is. You are just a fool to be suckered in by the corporate media who do nothing but promote themselves and to promote products and to promote money, and you're the fool that's buying it. Look who is the fool. You probably subscribe to the top 40 tunes on iTunes. And you probably will do whatever the mass media tells you to do, because you probably believe everything that you hear. Because you know what they say? It's great that the mass media is controlled by a corporation that is very greedy to have money. It's great, despite the fact that we pay a $60-$70 cable bill and want to be entertained, but we're not being entertained because the mass media is promoting a bunch of crap on TV. But I guess people like you make up that audience, because you are one of the audiences that love whatever mass media gives you, right? Anyway, enough about the mass media, which probably should one day end and die. But anyway, let's see. It's always been the responsibility of the individual to seek out that which offers a bit more in the way of inspiration. And when you get down to it, there are numerous forums available for anyone willing to take the extra 2 minutes. Well, you see, that's the thing. Nobody is willing to support any alternative media because they're brainwashed just like you. They don't want anybody else to be on TV except who the mass media wants to put on TV. You understand? Because they don't want public TV. They want to stop it. They don't want the internet. They want to stop it. They want you to watch what they want to show, and you, like a fool, are watching it. So there are no more individuals, because they're all brainwashed, and they don't know about other sources of media because they're too close-minded. You see, they don't get it. But you probably are not getting it either. You're probably staring at my drool. Ah, it's tasty. It's really tasty. Oh, and he continues. Your whining is even more of a put-on than your beat sketches. I didn't know that I was whining. Was I really whining? Am I not allowed to whine on public TV? Is this really bad? I mean, whatever happened to freedom of speech in America? I don't have rights. I can't say what I want to say. I'm not allowed to whine. I can't speak my mind. Oh, it's public TV. Maybe I shouldn't say anything. Should I go along with the corporate media? Should I say what they want me to say? I should not say what I have to say. I shouldn't have an opinion. Oh, but doesn't that contradict the America freedom of expression, freedom to speak? Oh, but perhaps we don't have that anymore. I'm forgetting. I keep forgetting. The corporations are taking over, and we just don't. Well, I guess we're just not gonna have any more rights anymore. Anyway, beat sketches. What does that mean? Who's beating who? I don't understand. I didn't know my sketches were beating people. Who's getting a beating? I wanna know. Are we getting a beating? Who's beating my sketches? Anyway, that was a long email from Steve Latukia, which is probably a fake email. So, thanks very much for the viewers' comments, and feel welcome and free to send me as much viewers' comments as you'd like, because I've got to read it on air. It's great. It gives me more material so my weekly show can be fresh and original. So, thank you once again. Oh, it was quite a long letter, and my voice is getting really, really tired, but thank you again. Thank you for watching the real me, Raw and Exposed. Yankee Doodle King D-Tag, riding on a brownie, stuck a feather in his hat and caught it back a rooney.